Okay, welcome back to this week's edition of the BarroomBlitz.com. Right here at Casey's Place in Quakertown, we're bringing sports talk back to where it belongs, right here at the corner bar. I got the golden one. I got Mr. Cheeks.
I just want to say, we're giving away bobblehead, Doug Shaw bobblehead. Yes, that's our new thing we're giving away.
Every week?
If you come to the Blitz and watch, we'll give away our Doug Shaw bobblehead figurine. And it's really ugly, let me tell you.
Former member of the show.
Former. With a big F.
Couldn't stand the heat. All right, let's bring up the Eagles preseason game last Thursday night.
Wasn't too bad.
Looked pretty good, Cheeks.
I thought they looked real good.
They got some stuff going on here.
Yeah. I didn't know they knew how to run that fast of an offense, and it was fast. The refs were tired.
Refs don't know what to do.
The water boy had to come out for the refs.
Sure.
The chain gang
like,
has
need some water.
Very good. He needed it.
The chain gang has no recollection. They're gonna have to get the young guys in for the Eagles games because man, that went pretty quick.
They were moving, man.
And he had plays. I didn't know what was going on, and I learned one thing: Foles can run it.
Yeah,
but
absolutely.
He's gotta quit throwing stupid. He had turnovers the last two games.
Yeah. Dumb turnovers.
Michael Vick looks better.
You're going to start. There's no doubt. Let's start.
Absolutely.
Let's stop the whole quarterback controversy.
Right.
They had someone. My dad was telling me this morning. They had someone on the radio. Don't wait. Wait till the first game. Tell him. He goes, because Mike. I think it was Gary Cobb said it on the radio. And he said, let him wait because he's obviously practicing and playing harder, not knowing who the starter is.
Absolutely.
But I think what you do is you go into the season and you put Michael Vick there. Because if you put Nick Foles in there, and say he falters a little bit, he's got a four-time All-Pro player and an MVP standing there, sitting in the locker room, waiting and
wondering
waiting.
So
if they start Vic and he doesn't get it, Foles just slides in and does what he can then.
Absolutely.
He can
start Vic.
I think Chip Kelly's going to run both throughout the game. I really do. He's done
quarterback committee?
He did it with Oregon three times.
Can that work in the NFL, though?
Well, the Dallas tried it. It was successful with Morton and Staubach. But Chip Kelly don't give a shit. You know what? I think he thinks Foles can throw the ball a little better.
I think he thinks Foles can handle the offense.
He's still inconsistent and inexperienced.
He doesn't have the arm.
He got in the red zone the other game. He threw a pick on the first possession.
I don't know what he was trying to throw. He was trying to throw it away, and he threw it right there.
And plus, how about that one play when Foles rolled to the left, and he did a quick screen to the left side? And I remember one of the announcers was like, that ain't going to work in the NFL. I mean, what? That's really risky to do that. What if he drops it? That's a fumble right there. That's a lateral.
Right.
Well, but that's Chip Kelly's offense. I think, you know, if he sees
Vic. It's high risk, high reward.
Exactly, right.
If he sees Vic stuttering and stumbling and throwing it into players' arms, hey, come on, Nick, you're in there. I really think that's
now, with this high-powered offense and these quick plays and stuff, how in shape does your defense have today?
Oh, absolutely.
Like, I mean,
everyone
they're sucking wind.
Shape. They were
the linemen are standing up there like, you have to have
a hell of a transition for a 16-game season and stuff like that. I mean, that's a lot to have. But like I said, it shows a lot of promise. And it was because I didn't really get to watch too much of the very first game, just little bits and pieces and some of the highlights and stuff.
Well, they didn't run that. They didn't run it.
Yeah.
They didn't run it.
But they came out full force.
I think that was it. Yeah. That was it.
It's going to be interesting. I mean, they're going to put some points up. So get your fantasy players ready. That's a lead-in for a segment later, just so you know.
You know, and McCoy looked he looked slow on, like, two runs they had early, and they had him out.
Then he had that one big one.
Right, the one run.
Fired it up, man. Yeah. I'm like, man, because I was sitting there.
He juked some out of their jockstrap.
I think he's tired, because they took him right out. And he was like this. I don't know if he was cramped up early or excited.
Yeah, maybe.
But I tell you, that boy got some moves.
He does.
He's got some stuff going on there, Chief.
He's got some. You could talk Poke and all the Brown and all them other douchebags, but
they don't touch McCoy.
No, he can run.
He's set
for that offense. You get him
going
out there.
Oh, he's perfect.
Perfect.
Could you imagine like a guy like Barry Sanders in that offense?
That'd be dangerous.
You know, like you spread him out all the time rather than just put him in the line.
Get him in the open field.
Exactly. All that free
space. That's what he's doing. He's creating space for him to go instead of this off tackle and bunched up.
And you're going to see with this offense, too, is you're going to have – they're going to be at an advantage because the defense won't be able to get those guys out there for the change. You're going to have to change your whole defensive philosophy if it works. I mean, I know it's preseason – But if it works, you're going to have to change your whole defensive philosophy.
It's going to be hard to scheme for them, absolutely.
Yeah, because you're not going to be able to get your substitutions in. I mean, I know there's a rule, NFL rule, on substitutions on guys getting in the game, but they're going to change the rules, man.
Absolutely.
It's going to change the game.
You're going to see a lot of them injured.
Yeah, like cramped.
A lot of cramped up, down on his knee.
My back. A lot of soccer players.
A little bit of McNabb throwing up in the huddle.
They're going to try to break it up.
You didn't have to go there.
But I guarantee you, Dallas, the Giants, and Washington are looking at it and go, oh, man, they're planning on, they're wide. They must have watched that thing.
They're going to do the old Buddy Ryan, Andre Waters laying on the field.
they're like, we got to slow this thing down.
Well, that's what the teams were doing in college. They were faking injuries. They were laying down.
Right. Certainly.
I remember one game. I was watching one game where the two guys looked at each other and they both fell over.
Yeah,
awesome. Didn't know who was going to go out. All right, well, why don't we take a quick break, and we'll be right back with some more Barroom Blitz.
.com.
Sorry, Pete.
Pete just got to his beer. Our Dougie bobblehead is available.